and head civil engineering department, Walchand Strata, Solapur. So today let us discuss about a numerical example on design of open well staircase. Learning outcomes: at the end of this session, the learners will be able to determine the effective horizontal span for an open well stair and effective thickness of waste slab for each flight, and determine the reinforcement arrangement of each flight and sketch the reinforcement arrangement. Example: a stair with open well is having a steps of size 280 mm by 150 mm. So this is 280 is tread and 150 is rise. The arrangement of the stair is as shown in figure 1. Arrangement is already given. So design the stairs for a live load of 3 kN per meter square. Use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. Sketch the reinforcement details. Now this is a plan showing arrangement of steps. So this is flight AB. This is first flight. Here we find 1, 2, 3 up to 10. These are treads, and 11 it is quarter landing. So this is AB flight. Then this is BC flight. BC flight is perpendicular to the hull. So here we get tread 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 treads are there. And again a landing over here. And CD, it is again a third flight. So AB and CD, they are similar, whereas BC is different. Solution. Step 1, effective span. For AB and CD, effective span L is given by 0.15U plus 2.8, this is going portion, plus 1.4 plus 0.15. 0.15U is the thickness of the wall which they have taken here, or the thickness of half the thickness of beam or wall. So whether it is here there is a beam and here there is a wall. So half the thickness, wall is taken here 300, beam is taken here 300 mm width, and here wall is taken 300 mm width. So half of that will be taken every time. Then these treads, this is going portion and this is again landing portion. Now here we get, this is 4.5 meter. And BC, it is 0.15, 1.4, 1.4, 1.4, plus 0.15, that is the 4.5 meter. Then, does the flights have effective span of 4.5? All are 4.5 here, fortunately. Hence, the thickness of waste slab is 125th of span to 120th of span. So, it is 200 plus overall thickness they have taken as 230 mm. Then loads. Considering 1 meter wide stair, load on going portion. So weight of waste slab is 0.23 is the total thickness into square root of 1 plus r by t square into 25 is density. So that works out to 6.523 kN per meter. Weight of steps, half of r into t divided by t. So into 25, that will give us 1.875 kN per meter. Say the finishing load is including finishing load, say it is 9 kN per meter with finishing load. Then live load is 3 kN per meter. So factored load, it is 1.5 times dead load plus live load, it is 18 kN per meter. Load on landing. So weight of landing, it is 0.23 into 1 into 25, 5.75. So weight of finishing, including finishing, it is 9 kN per meter. So live load 3 kN per meter. So total load 9.75 kN per meter. So factored load is 14.625. Now please see, on factored load on going portion is 18, whereas for landing portion is 14.625. Where will be the maximum bending moment for flight AB? Where the maximum bending moment for flight AB is at a distance x from A, where the shear force is 0. So we get maximum bending moment where shear force is 0. Therefore, we have to write an equation for shear force and equate it to 0 to find out the x. So figure 2 shows the load on this particular flight per meter width. This is flight AB. So this is RA, RB. So this portion, it is steps, weight is there, therefore this is more, and this is landing portion, therefore load is less. So RA is calculated by taking moment about one of the support. It is 39.6 kilonewton. Then by we'll take a section at distance x, and if we just divide by loading on it, that is the load coming, that is at 2.2 meter from A, we get maximum bending moment. Here the shear force is zero. So maximum bending moment occurs at 2.2 meter from A, hence the design moment mu is equal to this much, that is 39.6 R reaction into 2.2 minus this downward load, 18 into 2.2 and 2.2 by 2. So it is 43.56 kilonewton meter. Step 4, reinforcement. AST is again calculated by using relation 0.5 FCKBD divided by FY into 1 minus square root of 1 minus 4.6 mu upon FCKBD square. So by substituting the values, we get AST as 646.6 mm square. Using 12 mm bar, spacing required will be area of 1 bar into 1000 divided by 646.6, that is 174.94 mm. So therefore provide 12 mm bars at 170 mm center to center. Then distribution steel. So this is perpendicular to the slide, that is the perpendicular to the main steel we are having. AST is 0.12% of the gross cross-sectional area, 0.12 by 100, 1000 is width and thickness is 200, therefore we get 240 mm square. So using 8 mm bars, spacing required will be area of 1 bar divided by 240 into 1000, it is 209 mm. So provide 8 mm bars at 200 center to center. This is regarding distribution steel. Next is for design for flight BC. Flight BC loading is different, flight AB it is different, therefore so we have to design AB and BC separately. So for flight BC, the loading diagram is shown here. The this is landing portion, therefore having lesser load, and this is going portion having more load, and again landing portion having lesser load. So due to symmetry, here the bending moment will be at the midspan. So therefore, we calculate RARAB reaction, then we calculate maximum bending moment, which is at midspan. So maximum bending moment works out to be 41.4 kilonewton meter. So the reinforcement, again determined by using 0.5 FCKBD upon FY into 1 minus square root of 1 minus 4.6 mu upon FCKBD square. So if we substitute all the values, we get AST is equal to 612.2 mm square. So the spacing of bars, it is area of 1 bar and 1000 divided by 612.2, that is 184.7 mm. So let us provide 12 mm torque, 180 mm center to center in this particular portion. Then distribution steel, again 8 mm diameter, 200 center to center. Now this is reinforcement detailing. So this is reinforcement detailing for the first flight, that is AB. Here there is a beam, here there is a wall. So then for we find the bottom steel. Bottom steel is main steel, that is 12 mm diameter bars at 170 mm center to center. It is provided bottom. And above that you get dots. These dots are nothing but this is distribution steel. It is 8 mm diameter bar, HYSD bar at 200 mm center to center. So here at the we get fixity. Therefore this bottom main steel is taken up to the top. So that is again you get top and bottom steel here. And distribution steel again in this portion where you have top and bottom steel, distribution steel is provided in a staggered manner. So next is the flight BC. For flight BC we are having landing here and landing at both the ends, and in between that we are having a going portion. So therefore here you get 12 mm diameter bars at the bottom, that is your main steel. So at 180 mm center to center, here it is 170, here it is 180 mm center to center. And this particular thing, again this is taken up to top and again we are having bottom extra bar z bottom. So then here again distribution steel staggered, and here the distribution steel 8 mm or 200 mm center to center. That, so this is how we are supposed to show the two sections in case of open well staircase. So one for the two flights on either side and one for the central span, that is central flight. So these are references used for preparing this particular presentation. Thank you.